reach ah.
Yeah.
Oh, so kena tuning ah.
Little bit only lah, but it's look okay lah, not bad lah.
What is the prognosis?
So what we see here is out of from 8 shim or 8 valve located on your exhaust, 6 of them is already out of tolerance lah. If you see, not all are out of tolerance. What we are looking at the center line of the tolerance lah. The tolerance start from 24 to 31. This is the tolerance accepted lah. So the center line of it is 28. So we try to bring our valve or the shim or the clearance is between 28 lah. So if you look here, this is exactly what happened is out of tolerance, right? This is inside the tolerance, but this is quite far from the center line. So we'll try to bring it to close to 28. 25 is inside tolerance, but we have like 3 points. 23 is out of tolerance, 21 is out of tolerance. So we'll see the shim, we check the thickness of the shim, we do the calculation and later on we'll replace lah. Intake, we have 2 which is out of tolerance. The rest is inside tolerance and it's accepted value lah.
The chain is okay lah?
Yeah. Chain is okay, marking is okay, didn't fly off. To open this, you have to be like this lah. When you open this, you cannot open just one side. So you have to basically distribute the load lah. If not, this one can crack, you know.
You do the measurement first, then only open?
Yes.
Kalau buka dulu, lain?
Then how you know which shim is need to be replaced, which shim is usable? Because remember, when you do off clearance, you want to check the clearance. If I straight away open, which valve now is out of tolerance, you don't know. And that's why you do the measurement first and then you pull out the shim. Each shim you measure it. This the height here is as per the manual spec. Sometimes
boleh makan
you can.
What's the reason you makan?
Minyak, type of oil you're using, you can oil. So if it less friction oil, then what happens is it start creating more friction here. Like less viscosity oil, so the viscosity is out when high temperature. So what happened, you have to create more friction here. So sebab tu, you have to select the right one, like Motul 300B, it's very good oil. But the problem is, it become very very thin. This is the shim inside here. Thank you. tensioner working good. So this is what we call as a automatic tensioner. Okay, a tensioner used to tension your timing chain. Alright, so how does this shit work? Okay, sorry for the word. So how does this thing work? It's basically, it's been assisted by a spring. Alright, this spring is always under compression. Okay, when you connect this this screw in, when you screw this this bolt in, so the spring will be always under tension. Alright, so what it does, when you have a slack on your timing chain, the spring will assist to push the tensioner, the body here, the head here. So your timing chain will be always on tension. Okay, if this thing stuck or it doesn't work, by any case this tensioner doesn't work, so you will have a slack on your timing chain. So what can this thing do? So basically you have a possibilities of the timing chain went off from the sprocket lah, timing sprocket. Then you will have a offset of the timing. So that could lead to knocking, which is your ni lah, waft to touch with your piston lah. Alright, so this is how it works. Simple, very simple. Alright, fucking shit bro. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, eh? So if you put 7 here and I put here inside, right? See, yeah? I push, you can all the way in. You see, there is no gap. This is just by my hand. See, there is no gap here. Nah, dalam tu, kan? Tak ada gap. So sepatutnya it has a slight bigger gap like this before you give tension. Macam ni sikit before. It should be like this with hand. Tapi kau nampak, sekarang aku boleh tekan ni, nampak? Ha.
Sakit.
dia kum, pum, pum. Tu aku nak tengok plug ni. Kalau dia plug ni pump, this is the vein lah. It should be 0.5 lah. Dia punya gap kan.
Can you believe it? It's 9 o'clock at night. 12 hours. Finally done at 66 speed bike. Got a whole lot of stuff done to the bike. Tip top workmanship with the legendary touch of the Sifu Ahmad Khan. What did I do to the bike? A lot of stuff. Really a lot of stuff. It's the 40,000, almost 40,000, it's like 39.9 roughly. But to me, I'll just round it off as 40,000, since it's not much of a big difference, couple of hundred kilometers. What did I do to the bike? Well, I did a lot of stuff which I have been putting off. The main thing will be the valve clearance. So, looking at the video, there was about 7 valves that needed to be worked on, needed to be adjusted. Other than that, what else did I do? I did the air filter cleanup. Cleaned up my DNA air filter and applied new lube for it. The other thing I did was also the fork service, front forks. I'm putting the Liqui Moly, the heavy fork oil, the heavy type, So I haven't tried this before, so I'm curious to see how it performs. Definitely stiffens up the bike. What else did I do? Well, I did the oil change, fully synthetic, Liqui Moly. Whoa, what the fuck. With the oil filter as well. Next up will be the coolant. Changed out the coolant. Put fresh coolant in. I did a valve cleansing, Liqui Moly as well, valve cleansing. Why did I do it? Well, since I already got the bike almost all stripped down, and I had new spark plugs, yes, new spark plugs as well. So I had a valve setup, valve clearance check, new spark plugs. So I was thinking might as well I just get the valves cleaned up. So quite a lot of stuff done. Took a whole day to do it. Overall, I would say that this is what you need to do if you're having a sport bike, a high CC bike, big bike. Definitely need to spend. The total cost of the work done is roughly almost 2,000 ringgit. To me, that's pretty fair considering all the work that was done to the bike. I would say that's a pretty fair trade-off in terms of the price point. Workmanship, labor, yeah, good stuff. Definitely I would recommend 66 Speedbike. You get to meet the legendary Sifu. He'll share you some good information, some nice explanation done. And should I be on a different lane or something like that? I'm not sure, man. I think I should be going up or down. Oh, kereta rosak ke? The engine is definitely feeling much more alive. It's like a, almost like a virgin bike back to the original. In fact, it could be even better than the original setup of the bike. With all the suspension done, valve clearance check, check to spec, cam tensioner, everything checked. I'm pretty satisfied. I did allocate the whole day for the bike, and I did allocate a lot of things to be done to it. What's left to do is, if I'm not mistaken, the next service at the 45 mark, that will be for me to get my chain and sprockets. Those are coming up. The chain itself right now is not too bad, but definitely need to save up on that. Chain and sprockets, as well as the battery. If I'm not mistaken, the battery is getting me close to 3 years now, 2 years plus, I guess. So it's pretty much about time to look forward to a new battery. That should be the extra stuff that I need to do. So that's it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video showing the bike process of getting the work done onto it. Stay tuned for the next one when the time interval comes along. Till then, this is the Cyborg. Ride safe and safe ride, guys.